Hello fellas, welcome to Attraction. Today we will try to add this type of crochet lace in our project. So without delaying, let's get further. Our first task is to find an appropriate lace for our project. For that, I am searching on Google. You can simply write lace or crochet lace to get the result. While finding the lace sample, keep in mind that the lace should be lying flat in the image because more distorted the lace, more hard it will be for you to extract lace sample from there. If you have your own design for lace, then you can click its image and follow the following steps that we are going to use further. Now our lace is decided, but we have to use Photoshop first before adding it in our project. This is how our lace looks normally. It has a black background behind it which we don't need. So I will remove it by the help of color range option available to us here. Now, create a guideline for making your lace completely straight and try to distort it. If you are using the image of your own lace, then I will recommend you to put it straight while clicking so that you can skip this part. Now, crop or select your image in a manner where you get a decent repeat of it. Don't forget to save it in PNG format to keep its transparency. Otherwise, our effect will be useless. Now, we can go back to our cloth 3D. I have a pre-created project, so I will open it here. This top is kind of boring, so before adding lace here, I prefer to add some prints in it. I have this cute little print, so I will add this here. It's better this way, right? I don't want to see my avatar currently, so let me hide it by pressing Ctrl A or use this option from here. I want to add lace down the hemline of this top. So for this, we have to measure it to decide the length of our lace. We don't want it to be shorter. I know we can increase it as much we want later too, but why waste time when we can save it? I will measure only the half of it, so two parts of front and two from the back. Don't forget to press the shift while selecting these. Otherwise, you won't have the total of it. Here we got 31.561, which means we need to create two rectangles of this length, but keep in mind, height should be according to the lace size. So I am keeping it 0.75 inches only. If we look closely here, we will see the same print as of our top. And to remove this, we have to add new fabric here for us. For assigning it, you can either use this arrow here or can simply drag it over your pattern. Now we can add our lace as a texture to include it in our project. Browse your image from here. Here it is. Press OK. Let me close 3D window to show this to you. Our lace is not completely visible, so we will use Edit Texture tool to make the changes. If you don't know how to use some of the tools, then you can check the description box for the connected videos. It's okay in size now, so make a copy of it. It's time to stitch this with the top. I am using Free Sewing tool. It's not possible to explain the use of all tools in detail every time, that's why I recommend you to watch them from the description in case. It's time to arrange it, so here is our 3D window Use impose option to avoid any distortion during simulation. We can simulate it now. It's ready, but we haven't stitched it from the sides yet. So here we go. It's all done, but have you noticed that one part of lace is pointing upward? To rectify this issue, strengthen this part. Now we can normalize it since it's corrected. This is how you can add lace in any of your project easily. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, make sure to give us a like, and also don't forget to subscribe, and not just subscribe, ring the bell icon so that you, my friend, don't miss any other future tips and tricks or tutorial. Till then, stay tuned and keep creating. Bye.